Nityananda.
Go ahead, ma.
Swamiji, I just wanted to share something. This is not a question. But I actually went to Badrinath, to Brahmakapala, to do the Shraddha, to do the Pinda Tarpana for my ancestors a few years ago. They told me I cannot do it because I'm a female, and you have to be a male and you have to be the eldest son in the family. So they have a lot of restrictions. So it's not very easy to do those. And I think the Maheshwara Puja, it's just we sit right here and it just happens. We don't have to worry about. And nowadays the roads are not even accessible very easily to these places.
No, not only that. You see, listen. In that rituals, in the 13, anything related to the dana, women can do. Like a godana, budana, swarnadana, avastradana, annadana and all. Rituals, basically women are not allowed to do in the later days of Hinduism, the post-Shankara time, the ritual was, all rituals were banned for women. That is the reason this rule came. Okay. But originally in the Upanishads and Vedic period, there are records, women doing Shraddha and even last rites. There are tons and tons of records and enough of records. And even the Shraddha Mantra, in Shraddha Mantra, where the priest asks the person who is giving Shraddha to hold the rice and the till, he addresses male and female. Please understand, he addresses masculine and feminine. And there are at least few places we have enough references and enough of evidence where women were asked to give Shraddha and participate in the rituals. Now what you are saying that in Badri it is not happening is just recent times, maybe last 600-700 years, the male chauvinistic. That is the reason the Shraddha was stopped for women. You guys take this reference and go and do Shraddha in Badri and tell them, my guru is Mahamandaleshwar, he has given this reference. You tell whether this sutra is right or wrong.
Yes, Swamiji.
Is this sutra original? Is this mantra original?
Yes.
He says, yes, it is original. Then allow me to do Shraddha. That's all.
Yes.
Swamiji, Pitru Doshat Kaga Pandra Pooja, Maheshwara Pooja is the same?
Yes, it is one and the same.
Swamiji, what if we don't have any photos or any birth time?
No, I cannot do Maheshwara Pooja. You have to have either birth chart or the photo. Other, without that, I won't be able to offer.
Swamiji.
Go ahead.
While in Kailash, with you, we paid the tarpana, what are the...
I think that's enough.
That's enough. Second is, when you say they will be relieved of all the, after the Maheshwara Puja, relieve of all the karmas. I thought it's only the incompletion.
Well, all your karmas are actually incompletion.
Even the past life?
Yes.
Okay.
Even the need for breathing is an incompletion.
No, but my question is this. In the present life, there are the incompletions, let's say. But the karma is also from the previous life with somebody else.
In the past life incompletions only, you bring it as a karma in the present life also.
With the same soul?
May not be the same souls, but the carrier is the same soul, na? See, for example, past life you would have had a fight with your husband. This life you may be having a fight with your wife. But the pattern is same in as far as the recording inside, as a karma.
Right, but the, like my father, I might have incompletions which I took care of in Kailash.
That's all, that's enough.
Right, but his previous Jalma, what happened to
that? You see, when in the Kailash, when we gave Shraddha and all, whatever his other baggage he has, that also will melt down because we have given it in an elaborate way. Don't worry.
Thank you, Swamiji.
Swamiji, You said 13 days immediate within 13 days if you give do shraddha, the soul which is born will get released of all the karmas. And suppose he has taken another birth, and within that 13 days if we do the Maheshwara puja, he will the person the in another body he will get enlightened and leave the body as well, or
no, he will leave the body and he will not have karma, he will not take another one body, which means enlightenment.
Okay, but that that life he
no, that body which he has taken itself will be dead.
Okay,
the child will be dead within maybe 4 or 5 days.
Even if it's a healthy baby, the moment you have done your Maheshwara puja, it
so the milk he drank he will digest for 3 or 4 days and that's all.
How about the incompletion that the parents have towards the children?
Each soul is an individual soul and their journey matters. They will have another one kid, that's all. The individual soul's journey is more important than any relationship related thing. That's that comes as a first priority. Second only this.
Swami, ஒரு சின்ன சந்தேகங்க. What happens if the 13 days passes away?
If the 13 days is passed, I won't be able to liberate that child immediately. The further accumulation of the karma and the incompletions can be reduced. Life will be better without the influence of this load. That's all. But immediately the child cannot be liberated under.
So if something happens, we will do it within 13 days.
Soul will leave the body. It will not take one more birth. I'll cut the U-Haul service. Not only that, even if the road when I am traveling, if a dead body is being taken, that's all. Anything falls into my breathing space, even without knowledge, by accident, means when I am driving, there is an accident in the road and the body is still there, means over. That fellow is liberated. He can't have one more body. Because the U-Haul service will be disconnected. My breathing space is such, all U-Haul service will be disconnected. Means the karma carrying umbilical cord will be disconnected. So that cannot survive in my breathing space.
So Swamiji, all the bodies that when we are sitting in Manikarnika Ghat,
whole thing is liberated. Whole thing is liberated. Yes. All these fellows are liberated.
At least 40-50 were there.
More than that.
Swamiji, when I was in Hardwar, there was a sadhu who was on the bridge, and I put some money under his coat, his blanket, and I realized that night that he was dying. So I went back the next day, and I checked on him, and he was almost dead. And when I put the mala, I took off my mala and I put it on the top of his head. He shuddered and he died.
It is good. It means you liberated him. You helped him to free.
Good.
You put him in connection with me before he was dead. That's good. Go ahead.
Swamiji, you said the souls, even as long as they're in their breathing space, they get liberated. So does that mean it only can happen in your physical presence around your breathing space?
No. In my physical presence happens. When I connect with them also, that they become part of my physical presence.
Okay. So Swamiji, let's say we have a deity which has been done prana pratishtha, or your paduka which represents your presence there. So if
that will not be able to have such a strong radiation over a human being, because that being has to connect with it.
Okay.
My case, he doesn't need to connect. I myself can be actively involved in it. A deity will not actively involve. It will only wait passively, and whoever comes will be gracing. The Markandeya was active. So that person who is dying, if the person is active, the deity can do the job. Go ahead.
Swamiji, if a person does suicide in your physical space, then?
No. If a person commits suicide, even in my physical presence, I will not be able to help. Because it is a abusal. It's a, you are fighting against God. When you asked and He gave you the body and you destroying it is directly fighting against the cosmos. So nobody can help you.
Swamiji.
Nobody can help the person who commits suicide, even in my physical presence.
Swamiji, even animals assume a new body within 3 seconds, other than human beings.
No, animals, when they evolve only, they assume a human body. That also happens in within 3 seconds.
Swamiji, if the body wants to, if the soul, which has been born in a new baby, if you have liberated it, if it still wants to hold on to a body, get a new
body? It won't want to. When the karma baggage is not there, it will feel free and just jump out. Who wants to be inside the body when there is no karma baggage?
Swamiji, how is it then with enlightened babies getting born? Babies, enlightened children getting born, yeah, they don't have karma, right? So why do they keep their body?
No, that is incarnations. It's not that. Normally, all the children are born enlightened. No, no. Yes.
Swamiji, in the back.
Even in our end pregnancy, we bring a possibility for enlightenment more. Babies themselves are not completely enlightened. The possibility for enlightenment is more. And they are brought up in such a way that when they grow up, they will become enlightened. That's not that they are already enlightened when they assume the body. Next.
Swamiji, I already done the Mageshwara Puja through Swamiji to my parents. Still, I want to do one more time. Can I do?
That is up to you. You can.
Thank you.
Swamiji here. In the presence of energized padukas or deity or any object, if the person is leaving the body, will it become
less
painful?
See, what I am saying, that person, if he actively connects with me, I can do, but not that his feeling connection doesn't exist. See, when it happens in my physical presence, that person's active connection is not required. I'll do the active job. But in the Padukandal, that person has to be actively connecting it.
Will it be less painful for the...
Surely. Not only less painful, even liberation can happen.
Thank you so
much. If that person is actively connecting.
Thank you.
Swamiji, the children who they die within a day or two of their birth, that means are they getting liberated or they will be...
Yes, they will get liberated.
Within 13 days, because as you said, that karma
they
baggage...
They won't have the karma baggage, okay. So immediately liberation only.
Okay, thank you.
Swamiji, I wanted to share one experience. When I did my first Maheshwara Puja for my dad, since my dad died about 10-15 years ago, I didn't do any tarpana. That was a deep guilt in me that I should have done, but I didn't do. But that was an opportunity to perform the Maheshwara Puja. When I did the Maheshwara Puja and when you put your food in your mouth, I felt that something dropped from me, a huge weight. I physically, it was like a gross feeling that something left me. Because I had doubt also. How could this be liberating my dad and all that I was having? Because only 3 kshanas you need for you to take the next body. Since he died about 15 years ago, how could that happen? And all those things was running in my mind. When I did that, I felt that this was more than what I would ever imagine to do. Thank you, Swamiji.
Swamiji, one more question. Do the karmic laws affect incarnations the same way as they affect human beings?
No.
So incarnation can never accumulate bad karma?
No. It doesn't touch me.
Oh.
Then?
I don't know. I'm just asking because some people thought you face so much harassment and all that is not because of any bad karma.
No, you are also harassing me. What can I do? That is not because of my bad karma. I decided to be patient and answer you, that's all.
I have a question about in medicine, assisted suicide. Is that also bad?
Yes, suicide is bad in every angle. The Vedic tradition, Hinduism, does not accept suicide in any form.
So even if the person's suffering, you shouldn't do that?
Even if the person should be kept alive with all possible available scientific inventions, discoveries, as long as possible.
And if
doctors should not do the that what euthanasia.
Yeah.
Mercy killing, doctors should not do. At least for all my disciples, I tell you guys, even if you do mercy killing, you will be prosecuted for murder in the cosmos.
Okay. Alright.
So never ever do that.
Okay.
Never ever do that. Yes. All doctors, please do not, never encourage mercy killing. Never be part of the mercy killing. Don't even be a passive partner in that mercy killing process. Cosmos records it as a murder. So even if your country law accepts, cosmic law doesn't accept, so you step aside. You tell them, my religion does not agree with this. For religious reason, I will not approve or encourage, be part of it. You be very clear about it and step aside. It is straight murder. It is straight murder. Nothing can be done. If somebody is attempting suicide, that will be hanging as a ghost forever till that natural time of moving to the next body comes. Swami. Accident, he will not have suffering because he is not destroyed himself.
I'd like to participate in this Swamiji in the puja, but I won't be able to sit on the floor. Is it all right for me to sit on the chair?
You see, it's a Shraddha, it's a ground ritual where the food is supposed to be spread on the floor and offered. Okay. That is why.
Okay, thank you.
Sitting on the floor will be as important as I need a photograph.
Can I offer the puja to my husband's grandparents who I've never met?
Whom you never met? Yes, yes, you can offer.
I had two questions. One, is there a Hindu position on organ transplants, lung transplant, heart transplant?
The Hinduism is very clear. It accepts organ transplants.
Okay. Second, what about hospice care? If a patient is dying and wants to just take
hospice
natural...
Hospice care is accepted in Hindu tradition. It is encouraged.
Okay. Thank you.
As much as possible, the patient should be kept alive.
Swamiji, how about aborted life?
Aborted life. Actually, life enters only when the baby is coming out of the mother's womb. In that 3 seconds only life enters. When the baby tastes this prana, the breathing, the breath of the world, only at that time life enters. So inside the heart beating and all is the extension of mother's heart, mother's life.
Thank you.
In one body, please understand, inside one body two lives cannot exist.
Swamiji, there is a condition of newborn baby where the kidneys are not developed, so the lung is also not developed. So the baby is put on the breathing machine support, and the whatever 24 to 30 hours the baby was there on the support. So there is not a clear, we were unable to see whether even adding a blood pressure support medication for a low BP, whether will prolong the baby's life or not, because the lung is not developed, so the baby is going downhill on the breathing machine support, which is considered maximum for the breathing aspect.
So you have done everything best and then baby dies, no problem. But anywhere you lack, it is murder. That's all.
We were not sure at the time whether even adding the blood pressure support medicine.
No, what I'm saying, you had certain medical intelligence. Mm. With that, honestly, you supported only life.
Okay.
That's all.
Sure.
There ends.
Swamiji, one more question. The brainstem death, which we certify. Mm.
Even then, the body should be kept as much as possible.
Because after the group of specialists certify the brainstem death, they actually withdraw the breathing machine support and all the medications. So, is it considered?
Even that should not be done.
Okay.
Till the heart settles by itself.
Okay.
Should be supported.
So brainstem death is not considered a natural...
No.
Okay.
It's not death.
Okay. Thank you.
It's only a type of a karana sharira, the coma, causal coma. Yeah.